This is Sport Fishing Championship.
And this is the second day of the Mississippi Gulf Coast Billfish Classic. We're on YouTube, Peter. It's day two of three, and they're catching fish.
It feels like Sunday.
But it's really Friday.
Yeah.
Right in smack dab in the middle, we are seeing reports coming in throughout the day out there in the Gulf of Mexico. Again, they were doing their running at like 11 o'clock in the morning, hit a couple of hours, and they caught several fish yesterday. And today, it's been on fire.
They're roasting marshmallows up there. They must have the longest marshmallow sticks to make those s'mores like you've never seen before.
Never seen before. I mean, there's a lot of teams out on the water.
Gulf 80 to be exact, Robbie.
Very expansive. I thought it was 80 plus. I'll give you 80. You know what they're vying for? How much money?
$1.5 zillion.
No, it's just a million, but okay. That's a lot of money. And it's a little over $1.5 million. There's some of our featured teams that are out on the water, like Badonkadonk Rising Suns, also known as Grander Sunrise, Rebecca Bandito, Southern Charm, Quantified, Nikki Bella, Miss Mason, not to mention all the teams that have Starlinks on board typically that
Rebecca
are sending
us right up down the pipe.
Yeah, we're dragging on up. Look at that.
Top to the east side. They brought those fish up to the east side. They got two blue marlin dragging up, and Quantified making some interesting moves as always with two sailfish and three white marlin to jump into second place.
Yes, sir. The Boss actually didn't see Boss up in there. I don't remember them in that spot. They've jumped up into third because remember Real Crude was there when we took our break on CBS Sports Network. Time, I think, in 15th place. Maybe Bandito, one of our featured teams. Let's go on board our Garmin team spotter. This isn't an exact representation, but this is kind of where they're at, just south of the Mississippi Canyon there.
Bandito, we got the young man in the chair, 15 years old, sun's out.
Guns out.
It's early in the morning. Looks like they're either a sunsetter or
a sunsetter. Yeah, okay.
We got that afternoon, getting ready for shower time, a little sleep. Get ready for that evening fishing or that morning fishing.
What a way to end your day, though, right? I mean, this is day one, the first day of a three-day event.
Yeah, that's how you want to end the day, with a big blue marlin.
Was it a blue? I don't know. I know they caught a mahi-mahi.
All right, guys, good job.
I feel like, what's that, stripes? That's a jack.
And you see them fishing on it? Yeah, that I do remember that stripes with Bill Murray. That is an edge right there that we talked about earlier on CBS Sports. That is that current pushing the warm water up into the cold water, which is pushing the weed into that clump where the phytoplankton and everything lives, where the fish come to feed and where the marlin come to wail on them.
And I think, yeah, this is the mahi catch that we saw from Bandito. Either way, we're seeing a lot of guys and girls running that edge. As you had mentioned, not too far from the rig, if I remember right.
Listen, if you've got the right equipment, you got the right sonar equipment, and you can run along that line and you start marking bait, you start marking things, you're gonna work that line. Some lines are barren, believe it or not, Robbie. You'll come up to some clumps and they've got nothing, they've got no bait. You wanna find the clumps with a lot of bait, and apparently this one must have it because they are on.
That was Tucker Wade yesterday afternoon, about 5:40. They were able to get this fish in. Now you're saying not seeing bait. Is that a full visual or is that a sonar, a graph thing where you're looking for bait?
It can be both. You know, sometimes you're up in the tower, you look down as you're cruising past it and you'll see little jacks coming out, small fish coming out, you know, when they see you come by, or you'll mark them maybe 50, 60, 100 feet down and you'll see schools of bait that's kind of hanging out low, be under the weeds.
There you go, work it.
Some nice equipment right there. What a dream come true. I wish I would have had this opportunity at this age to be able to wind on marlin on that kind of platform. That is just so fantastic. He is one lucky young man, and he's good at what he does because he's got great teachers. And here's that double line coming out of the water. Reach right below the double, and you've got the release. 350 points goes to the man in the chair.
Was it really a blue? I thought it was a monkey. I feel lost as last year's Easter egg.
This is definitely a blue. You ain't not sitting in that chair for that long with that kind of bend in that rod and to be a mahi. If that was a mahi, it'd be about a 90-pounder foul hooked in the forehead.
Good job, Tucker.
They've already got the release. They've already got the video of it jumping, I'm sure. But now they're going to just pump it back up.
Yeah, man, you're right. It was a blue. Tucker caught a mahi earlier, about 2 hours before this, and a blue at 7:50. So I had the right day, the wrong time of day, Peter.
And here is the fish on the leader getting some wraps put on it, bringing it in. You're gonna wanna get that line off the mate's head if it indeed is up in his hair or wherever it may be. You wanna keep him safe, but he does have his mate saver. That is a nice blue. Look at the size of the top of that tail. That's only half the tail. I mean, that's gotta be 2 feet sticking out of the water.
I am.
That is a power propeller on the back of that big blue marlin.
I want the motherfucker, Cliff.
Okay, we hear you.
God damn, that's a big tail.
I told you that tail was big, Robbie.
Pull him up.
Bandito with a blue marlin, good enough for fifth place as it stands right now. That mahi doesn't count for points that they had caught prior, but that blue does. That's 350.
What a way to be big! Great job, Tony.
That would be a massive tie for fifth place right now. I got to get out my abacus. You're going to have to pick this thing up, Peter, because I'm counting the tie for fifth place right now. And once a work of art has jumped in there, we know that's that big boat, that, what, 90-something foot boat, a work of art winner before. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I think there's like 16, 17 blue marlin caught now from individual teams. That shows me that the blues are active, but it also shows you can make a big jump with just one more fish.
That's right. I mean, I counted 27 billfish thus far, and I know there's other fish that are being caught that way that haven't been reported to us. There's a good bite going on. There's some big fish being caught, and there's some creative fishing. Again, that quantified catching 3 whites and 2 sails jumping into second place out of nowhere, that speaks volumes for their technique, their ability to be able to shape-shift and do what they have to do to get up there on the leaderboard.
Now, typically we don't get these underwater camera shots, but I know your buddy sent you some stuff, and it shows you what it looks like underwater. You throw this in your spread, in your dredges there, and this is what it looks like.
Yeah, these are my good friends from the Fish Tank Sport Fishing. We fished a lot in Cabo, and this is their dredge cam. They've got marlin all over. They got 1, 2, you see one come up on the teaser, 3 on the squid chain, 4 coming up back into the dredge. This is a slew. I'm calling this a slew, Robbie.
Yeah.
This is a slew of marlin coming up on these teasers.
Instead of Seattle slew, it's saltwater slew. Is that another teaser that's actually behind some of these fish?
Yeah. You got the squid chain. They're all eating up there. There's 2 up there. There's 2 in the back. We got 4 or 5 fish coming up.
That's a gaggle of billfish.
It is a gaggle of billfish. There's probably a gaggle of geese back on shore saying, hey, did they just steal our name? Yes. He is whacking that teaser. I mean, this is total mayhem on the boat. You don't have enough hands to clear this situation.
Right then, I was going, you're going the wrong way. No, he knew what he was doing.
Well, what's happening is they're stopping the boat. If you notice, the paddles have slowed down, and then they're going to be dropping the baits back, and they're going to try to catch a couple of them.
Look at the deeper ones.
Oh, they're just chilling.
The deeper ones just sitting there peeking up.
That's a massive school of fish.
Dude.
You know, birds of a feather flock together, gaggle of geese. There you go.
That is crazy. Yeah, I missed that the first time I saw it. Look down at the bottom
of
the screen.
Thank you, Fish Tank.
Yeah, that might be my new favorite. Peter,
that's a pretty good one.
That might be
pretty,
my new favorite.
Pretty good.
Rebecca, you can come out of the harbor there, and you can turn right, you can turn left, you can go straight. This is the furthest west team that we have of our featured teams.
You know, you've heard the phrase, go west, young man, back in the day, and that's what they did. They didn't get a chance to practice fish, they didn't get a chance to do much, and they also didn't want to spend their time just putting the baits out in unknown territory. They had heard that there was a good bite going on far to the west, and that's exactly what they did. They've got their fuel bladders, probably an extra 400 gallons of fuel on the deck of the boat. They use it, put the bladders away, and soon enough they're hooked up with a blue marlin doing exactly what they said they were going to do. They followed their plan, and he is locked and loaded. That fish is ripping drag.
We saw, you know, just before the sun set with Bandito catching a fish. Now we see as the sun rises with Rebecca, Is it like oftentimes you'll see with freshwater fishing when they like that early and late bite?
Yes, and then those great days is when they bite all day long. You know, we've had days where they shut down for a couple hours, and I it's something to do with, you know, the planet alignment. It's something to do with the lunar pull, the moon, everything, the tides. I mean, there's so many factors involved on what makes them come up and eat when they do. And sometimes we'll get them at 12 o'clock. They shut off until 2. You'll get them back at 2. And then it's almost lines out, guys, in 2 minutes. And all of a sudden, the fish start biting, and you got fish on every bait. Okay, lines out of the water. And you're like, oh, my God, if I just had 5 more minutes, I could have done some damage.
He might have at least 5 more minutes reeling this bad boy. Make it up ground, though. Big
They're
reel, big line.
They're flying in reverse right now. He's winding fast. They are cranking. You can hear it. You can see it. And then it kind of, you know. And another thing to do, Robbie, as I watch these shows, you always want to, if you can, in this situation it's tough, but if you're fighting a fish and you're going that fast in reverse, you want to pull up and wind. Even though you think it's going to like take up too much time, you want to pull that scope out of the water. So every pull up raises that belly of line up higher in the water column, and it makes you get more connected to that fish much faster.
And fast is relative too. I mean, these are relatively fast reels, but I mean, it's not anything crazy. When that boat's backing up, that's gaining considerable ground.
Yeah, you remember we talked about it when we were in St. Augustine about those Okuma reels. A lot of these reels are 3.1, 3.4 to 1, so you're only getting about 4 or 5 feet
that's
per crank.
Slow, right?
So, I mean, you're cranking, you know, you're 5 feet, 5 feet, 5 feet, you know, it's you better have a good shoulder. You better have a good bicep.
Well, when we watched the catch back and then looking back through some of that footage, said, man, I need a right-hand reel. Well, here's the case. This gentleman's got a right-hand reel. The other one had a open face.
Have you ever grabbed a spinner when the handle's been switched to the other side, to the right-hand side?
Yeah, it feels
awkward. I freeze up. If it's not on the left, on a spinning reel, I freeze up and I don't know what to do, and I just stare at it for a second.
Well, how many people, I mean, you've done this a lot, and we're not gonna say any names. How many people have you seen that don't know how to reel with their left hand, turn it upside down and reel that way? Or do you even let them do that?
I won't let them. I'll see it and I will immediately run to them and recommend that they don't ever do that again, ever.
Ever.
I have seen people reel the handle backwards off and it's on the floor,
yes,
and they tell me this reel is broken.
Yeah, it
is. This reel is broken. Okay,
thank you.
So what we have here is a little bit of a tail wrap, a little bit of a body wrap. Rebecca worked that fish and they got that fish lassoed up and it's coming to the boat. Another nice fish, big shoulders, big tail. They got this fish next to the boat and they're gonna do the mate saver cutaway any moment here.
And that's why it took a while. I mean, that fish was coming in sideways, and they were making ground. It didn't affect the fish much. Instead of him trying to pull it sideways through the water, they just went back to the fish.
Yeah, that's why they went back so fast. They probably identified that it was indeed tail wrapped at one point. Sometimes they come up and you can just all of a sudden, you know, they're on the surface doing their thing, but then they get really nasty when they're tail wrapped and it's difficult to bring them in until they relinquish control.
You see that look? He's like, give me 5. He's like, I'm gonna give you 4 knuckles because I can't lift my hand up. My arm is wore out. Catch alerts from day 2. It started off this morning at 7 a.m. It got after it early. Metal Masher with a blue marlin. But look at all the blue marlins you'll see on the line. Love that sound. We love hearing that sounder.
Code Blue, Rebecca, work of art. And then my boy Sid Little on the Miss Mam with his young Tate Yancey, 11-year-old, catching that nice marlin with his dad, Bruce Yancey, you know, putting it all together. That is something else to have it be 11 years old to be able to do that.
Matt Klossman had the group add, like I know Miss Virginia, a couple of these teams we didn't know earlier had fish. We called them in, double checked again. Everything we say is officially unofficial. What we did see when we were on CBS earlier was Quantify get into a mess of white marlin. They now have 3 white marlin in their catch already.
Yeah, they always surprise us, but we shouldn't be surprised by what they do. You know, they have one bad tournament, you go, oh, maybe they're not, you know, maybe they're not on it, but they are. They're on it, catching 3 whites and 2 sails, jumping into second place in a fleet of 80 boats. That is impressive.
Taking it to the grocery aisle. It don't matter, just looking. I saw Southern Charm in there, one of our featured teams. One of our teams we'll be following throughout the year. They have a blue marlin. We've got a really tight battle right now near the top of the leaderboard.
SFC coverage of the Mississippi Gulf Coast Billfish Classic is sponsored by Frito-Lay, Michelob Ultra, Denison Yachting, and by Salt Life.
When it comes to performance, comfort, and functionality, we've got you covered. Performance apparel designed by anglers to make your time on the water better than ever. Salt Life, the official apparel sponsor of the Sport Fishing Championship.
Whether you like to ride the wind, find your secret cove, or reel them in, plot your paradise with GPS Map Series from Garmin.
This spring, settle in and reconnect with one another. South Padre Island has so many great places to stay. Condos, resorts, and hotels. Oh my! Book your spring getaway today. And start making memories poolside with the people you care about most. Visit SoPadre.com.
When you're serious, you are as excited to wake up for a 4 a.m. fishing trip as you were when you were a kid. It means winning 3 World Sailfish Championships. It means you know what you need and what you don't. Being serious means seeking out the ultimate fishing machine, which is what Peter Miller has found in the unmatched handling, speed, and comfort of an Invincible.
Pine tar, bay rum, all natural, all natural.
It's time for your old soap to take up.
With Dr. Squatch, the best natural men's soap, deodorant, shampoo, and so much more.
Dr. Squatch is for players like Justin Herbert, who are here to shake things up,
who break records
and hearts, who are tough on the outside and soft on the skin side, who only use natural performance enhancement and want their end zone to be fresh.
Go to drsquatch.com today. Feel like a man, smell like a champion.
Are you ready for the ultimate luxury fishing experience? Join the Sport Fishing Championship talent on the SFC Experience, where you'll explore incredible fisheries and enjoy world-class hospitality from diverse cultures and SFC partner locations. With the SFC Experience, you'll create unforgettable memories with friends, families, or colleagues. Book your trip today and embark on the adventure of a lifetime with the SFC Experience.
SFC coverage of the Mississippi Gulf Coast Billfish Classic is sponsored by BioLite, Publix, Durabrite, and by Hop Water, a non-alcoholic sparkling hopped water.
Robbie Floyd and Peter Miller here with you. Peter, we need to go to our Publix, get some of that magic honey you've got, throw it in our hop water, nice and warm, and we need to hit Point Cadet Marina in Biloxi, Mississippi, just like they did last year.
This is not just a tournament. This is an event, and this is what everyone's talked about in this industry forever. When you have a tournament, you better have an event associated with it, and it makes it valuable. It makes it fun. It makes it family-friendly, and then they get to watch the weigh-in. It's just a win-win for everybody, and this is what bass fishing is always done, and now we're seeing this in the saltwater circuit during bill fishing on the Sport Fishing Championship.
Absolutely. It's a big presentation. I know for a fact that Salt Shaker caught a blue marlin this morning. Chris Hatcher has one boated. They will be bringing it in either today or tomorrow. Another team who has a blue marlin is Southern Charm, one of our top teams, one of our featured teams. This is a team to look for. I mean, a couple of third place finishes last year. They're trying to improve on that this year. And Katie Sawyer caught up with Connor McLeod of the Southern Charm yesterday.
This is a big competitive event. There's lots of boats fishing. And on top of that, Mississippi Billfish Classic, there's also the Sport Fishing Championship upstate. How do you feel about being part of the SFC?
I love it. You know, it's fun to be able to look back even sometimes at what we've did on previous weeks and learn from things and also see what other people have going on their boats. Even if it's not something that really catches our eye, if it works, you know, you might just kind of notice it a little bit. But overall, the advertising it's doing for the Billfish Foundation in general is probably the biggest reason, I think. It's the best benefit for it.
Well, there's some of the, what was that?
I was just going to say that's just awesome that people are talking about that, about, you know, the Billfish Foundation and tagging fish and learning about their migratory patterns, thus learning about the fishery, being able to catch more, being able to have a sustainable fishery for many, many years to come. And here we are with a big fish on. They're backing down. They're doing their thing. What is it, Robbie? What are they catching?
Blue marlin, Southern Charm earlier today. Should be Mackenzie Davis on the reel. She's feeding that line. Look at that.
Well, she touches you. Because they're going in fast reverse, and that fish is kind of coming at him. You know, so she's got to stay tight. For her to be able to do that like that, they were going a little fast.
She made the big old circle and just go back and forth, back and forth.
Yeah. That's when it becomes an X pattern.
Nice cross-hatching you have on
there. Yeah, that's very nice. You got to knit a nice sweater with that. But she's doing a great job. The team's doing a great job. They're always a team to look out for.
It got
Southern
harder.
Charm is always up there on the top of the leaderboard.
It got harder, didn't it?
Yeah, it sure did. That's when you got to bump it back forward. Fish settles down, and then we take another attempt at it. I'm so jealous, Robbie. I got to tell you. We've been talking about this fishing since 10 o'clock this morning, and I'm watching these marlin and
catch,
these reels dragging and people winding and pumping. It's like, whew, I want to get out there.
It's like living on your Instagram feed. I just watch you catch all these fish, and I don't get squat.
Well, come down and visit me.
I will one of these years. Kenzie fighting it in there again. Captain Landon Bell putting them on the fish of the Southern Charm, as always. Ron Davis, Connor McLeod, we heard from a moment ago. Lance O'Hea, Chase Richardson, another angler on board.
That's a loaded deck right there. You got a, yeah. Literally a loaded deck. They are backing down. You can tell that is a billfish. It's going towards the rig. It's not diving down. It's definitely scoping up. And that's what you want to see. Then you're able to tell what species. I'm sure they've already seen
it. It's a blue.
We haven't seen it, but I'm sure they've seen it. You could tell that line's coming, you know, straight at the rig. It's high up on the surface on the water column.
Awful quiet out there, isn't it?
Yeah. You notice the difference between the DR and the Gulf? Six people screaming at once, and here nobody's saying a peep.
Yeah.
It'll get your heart pumping. Boy, when everyone starts screaming.
Hey, but then again, with those inter-ear communication, they can speak quietly and not have to worry about yelling.
That's true. Sometimes you have a little too much cortadito or colada on the boat.
What was that?
Cortadito? A little coffee, a little milk in it.
Oh, okay.
Six scoops of sugar. And it becomes like where you could stand your fork up in it if you wanted to.
Café con leche?
See? Un poquito, por favor.
It's like your wife's from Ecuador.
She sure is. All right, look at that jump. Oh, man, that is a big, Robbie.
We upsized. Yeah, I love it. Hey, I'm glad you're finally.
She just supersized that fish. That fish out of nowhere just became a chunky monkey. That thing has shoulders like, I don't know.
Like Chris Jones?
Chris Jones, exactly. Chris Jones, I had him out on the boat. We'll talk about that in a minute. I had him out on the boat last week, and got a show airing tomorrow. Discovery is going to be a goodie.
Get deeper. You know, I got her.
Don't worry.
All right. Release. Release. Show me the release. Show me the hook.
Ron's like, no worries.
Let's go.
It sounds so much better when a younger person says it.
Let's go.
Hey, you see some of the official SFC action wear there? I saw the hat. Look at that. Look at that.
Absolutely.
He must have clicked on the QR code.
All kinds of hats on that.
On going up there. Captain Landon Bell, give him a high five as well. You can't leave out the captain. You can have all the fun down on the lower deck, but you've got to go give some love up top. Katie, so you know what that's all about.
There she is.
Look at your smiling face. We're in this chilly studio. It's all toasty there.
Katie, I got a question for you. I got a big question for you. So, are any of the teams out there expressing or having any struggles that you know about? Tell me about that. Is there any stress or struggles going on out there?
That's a great question, Peter. As far as we can tell, the weather has been exceptional out there. There's no white caps. The wind looks like it's not blowing hard. They haven't had any rough seas, but that doesn't mean that these teams aren't struggling with other things. With the tuna fishery being often predominantly in low light situations, often into the evenings, these teams have to decide whether they're going to get some rest for the marlin fishing or stay up late and try and catch a big tuna. That goes also with bait. If they want to load the tuna tubes with bait for the marlin, then they're going to have to sacrifice some rest. If they're not going to get, or if they're not successful in catching bait, they're going to have to be fishing lures. And with lures are J hooks, and that success rate, when you hook a fish with a J hook, you're more likely to pull the hook than if you hook it with a circle hook. There's also so much grass out there, you guys. So these teams are constantly battling with grass on their lines. They can't get a bite of a fish if they have grass on the hook, on the lure, on the tuna, any of it. So there's lots of struggles despite the fact that the weather looks super good.
Yeah, you bring up a great point when it comes to, like, what are you going to focus on? But some of these teams, like Southern Charm, Robbie just laid it out. It sounded like there might be 10 people on the boat. So you can have multiple shifts. You know, these three are going to take a nap. These three are going to catch bait. These three are going to fish. And they can kind of rotate. But on the smaller teams, that's exactly right. I mean, you got to rest up because you might catch a 600-700-pound fish. It might take you 5 hours. You never know. So that's a great point. Thank you for bringing that up.
Absolutely. And angler Mackenzie Davis on Southern Charm, she did such a fabulous job. That was a nice blue marlin. You could tell she was coaxing it up. The fish was comfortable. She was coaxing it up. And the second it came to the surface, the whole team, Captain Landon back down, they got the wire. Mackenzie got the leader in. It was really, really good. Absolutely.
A variety of boats. I know I mentioned a moment ago, Chris Hatcher has a blue marlin on Salt Shaker. He's going to be bringing that one in. Are you hearing any other reports of possible bring-in fish? All of our teams, again, everything we say is unofficial, but are you hearing things on the radio? Are they talking much? Are you, you know, with the communication we have now, are you able to talk to some of these teams out on the water?
There is a lot more communication now than there's been in the past, but as far as we know, there is that 121-inch fish, which is 11 inches over the minimum limit. That's a good-sized fish. It might be a skinny one. It might be a fat one. We don't know what it's going to weigh, but it's a good-sized fish. But that really brings us to an interesting point to me at the Mississippi Gulf Coast Billfish Classic that I think is really important to highlight. You guys talked a little bit earlier about the Billfish Foundation and the conservation levels here in this community. What is really exceptional about Biloxi is that it's essentially a giant citizen science program. They have the executive director of the University of Southern Mississippi sitting the board for the Marine Science Institute. He is a huge part of the decision-making process. And every time these fish are brought to the dock, there are specimens collected for them, either for NOAA, for the federal government, for universities all over the country, all over the continent. And it's really incredible. They're sending out some of the best fishermen in the Gulf of Mexico, some of the best bill fishermen in the Gulf of Mexico, getting information on where the fish are caught, where they're released, and also when they're brought back to the dock, they're getting information on how old they are, what they're eating, where they've been, if they're part of different genetic stocks. It's all very fascinating stuff, and they all work hand in hand with this tournament specifically and all of these fishermen.
That's really good. Thank you, Katie, for everything you've done down there. And yeah, the empirical data they get from these return fish. Again, the Sport Fishing Championship's about catch and release. We tie in with the local tournaments. We work our way from day one, top of the day. That first fish caught at 4 p.m., the first blue marlin caught and released by Real Crude. All the empirical data. One thing I know for sure, Real Crude, when they made their catch, 43-foot invincible. That's a center console, much like your boat. You're not going out 250 miles on this boat, but they got there quick wherever they were.
Oh, yeah. You know, with these calmer waters like this, they can fly out there. A lot of those guys with those boats, they will punch it. They'll put the knuckles to the fiberglass, and they're going 70 miles an hour to get to their spot. They've got their fuel bladders on there, and they are ready for everything. Those boats are loaded. I mean, you can't imagine how many things you can bring on a 43-foot Invincible.
And you've got to decide what you want to do. Do you want to make that quick run of burst? Maybe get to those fishing grounds, catch one, catch two. Maybe they can make that run along the coast. But Jammin' Graham, please tell me his first name's Weeby. Weeby Jammin' Graham. That would be so good.
Won't you like jamming with you?
Yeah. Captain Bill Spencer piloting that boat. Name sounds familiar, Bill Spencer. Day two, starting off this morning in a flurry through the midday. Look at that. From 8:47, we've got what? Several whites, yellowfin tuna, a couple of blue marlin as well. We haven't talked about that, our championship fish division. When we see that caught yellowfin tuna, they're probably not throwing out there if it's just a little guy. It's probably a decent enough fish that it could maybe challenge the Louisiana fish of 147.5.
Yeah, well, we did see Jaselyn with a big fish next to the boat. And unfortunately, it broke off, but that was definitely, I mean, in my eyes, that looked like a 200-plus pounder.
It could have been a good one. That's going to make you sick when you're Jaselyn Berthelot, and we saw her fight it. We went to break, saw her fight it when she come back. And you saw it, Peter. You saw the silhouette. You saw how big these fish possibilities are. You've caught a lot of fish. You say that's a 200-pounder that she probably lost right there.
I mean, it looked to me by the side of the boat, I saw the girth on that fish, and it looked like all of 200-plus.
All right, I want to bring up it. I'm not saying he's girthy. I'm just saying he's a big dude. He's a mean dude. He's a tough dude, and he plays for the Kansas City Chiefs. When we were at the catch, Chris Jones was with us. You were fanboying. He was fanboying on you. It was quite the deal. But I heard you went fishing with him recently.
That's right. We had a great time. We've been trying to fish together for 3 years, Robbie, and it finally happened. I called him. He said, Peter, let's go, but I only got 4 hours to fish. I said, we're going to shoot a show. I think we're going to catch some fish and have a good time. He jumped on the boat like we were old buddies, and we went to work. You guys got to check this footage out. It's some good stuff. I want you to see some of this, Robbie.
Hey, you did all the pre-prep earlier, and he just shows up and said, let's go catch fish.
I got to win.
Chris Jones is a two-time Super Bowl champ from the Kansas City Chiefs and is an absolute adrenaline junkie.
We brought him in. The Peter Miller way, baby.
Tackling high-pressure situations with skill and power.
Come here.
He's got a lot of heart.
I gave you $5,000 for you to eat it.
$5,000?
With extraordinary confidence.
This is a real fish.
Today, we play on the same team for one common goal.
And we're tight!
To win and win big.
Yeah!
Go!
Man, this is the goal, man.
You got a lot of heart, Peter Miller.
You got to check this episode out tomorrow, see if I actually ate that heart. Did I get that $5,000? Tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. on Discovery Channel, you're going to see it for reals.
I'm not stupid. That's like a roulette wheel and having your money on green, black, and red. I'm going to come out a winner on that guess for sure. Again, these guys gambling out there in the Gulf of Mexico. Currently, one team with a couple of blue marlin and a lot of boats trying to chase them.
In Puerto Rico, we call ourselves Boricua. We're proud, passionate, and full of life. On our island, adventure finds you. Strangers aren't strangers for long. The size of the audience doesn't change the beauty of the music. And we celebrate every last ray of sun. Live Boricua.
Salt Life, the official sunglass partner of the Sport Fishing Championship.
Well, we're waiting.
I'm all right. You don't know about it, but about me. You got to give me a fight. Why don't you just let me be? Come catch a day.
Amanda Shaw. We all know Louisiana is as fun as all get out. So get out, take a road trip, and explore our state. Fill her up, then try a new restaurant that's as fun-loving as it is food-loving. Grab the family and take off for monumental adventures at our 21 state parks. Or take a magical minivan tour along our 19 scenic trails and byways. Louisiana's a trip. Take one today.
This is Lieutenant Governor Billy Nungesser. Plan your road trip at LouisianaStaycation.com.
Whether you like to ride the wind, find your secret cove, or reel them in, plot your paradise with GPS Map Series from Garmin.
When you're serious, you are as excited to wake up for a 4 a.m. fishing trip as you were when you were a kid. It means winning 3 World Sailfish Championships. It means you know what you need and what you don't. Being serious means seeking out the ultimate fishing machine, which is what Peter Miller has found in the unmatched handling, speed, and comfort of an Invincible.
SFC coverage of the Mississippi Gulf Coast Billfish Classic is sponsored by Garmin, Invincible Boats. Visit South Padre Island. And by SFC Experience.
You want to be a part of that at SFC Experience. You sit in studio with us, have a good old time, Peter Miller, right?
That's right, or we'll fly out and meet you somewhere and go fishing and talk fishing and talk food and talk drinks and talk and be merry.
Block Island, that's our next go-to stop. I mean, Katie's going to them, Ronnie's going to them, Michelle's going to them, but we get to go to Block Island. We're talking about the Mississippi Gulf Coast Billfish Classic, Gold Nuggets, our host hotel. Just behind there, you'll see Point Cadet Marina in Biloxi. That's where the boats launch from. They'll return to there. That's where they will have the weigh-in. Not yes, ma'am, but Miss Ma'am.
Right, Robbie. This is one of our teams competing, and my friend Sid Little Lucky Charters, is back there on the boat with a young man, Tate Yancey, 11 years old.
Yeah.
He's whining on that fish. This is not his first one either.
No, it's not. And I was told earlier when we were talking about Tucker Wade, I thought he was 15. He's actually 13 years old.
He's built like a tank for 13.
I had some wrong information.
Okay, let's watch Sid. Let's watch Sid take these wraps and run across the cockpit here.
You're all about.
I mean, I'm just impressed. I don't remember him having this kind of oomph. I mean, he's aging. He's aging gracefully. He's powering on this fish. He said, Pete, I didn't have any time to let go of this fish. I had to get him with the boat. I mean, he is loving this. These mates live for these moments, okay? And his dad, you know, Bruce Yancey, is putting this whole team together, and it's a wonderful thing to have an 11-year-old in the chair doing this damage on this fish, and it's going to be a perfect release. That fish is powering a massive tail. Look at the propeller on the back of that fish. And Sid's hanging on like a champ.
I mean, they're moving. They're waking that boat. I mean, this isn't a no wake zone.
They're going 5 knots right there, 6 knots.
Or Wes, somebody, can you get the identifier again?
Identifier? Oh, well, you mean with the little tag? I was like, if you can't tell that is our Ocean Blue Yacht Sales replay of the day, if you can't tell that's a blue marlin, something wrong.
Yeah. You got to get your eyes checked. You got to go to my eye doctor, get the right prescription.
Is that another Salt Life glasses mentioned?
Yeah, Salt Life's been hooking me up with progressive lenses on my sunglasses and my reading glasses I'm wearing right now.
Our feature team's out on the water, Nikki Bella. Oh, beautiful Nikki.
Come back, Nikki, come back.
Love that Prince song.
Purple Rain, baby.
Right there on one of those little drop-offs there, a little bit lighter line, a little different technique. Just stick it under the armpit, bring her in.
That's right. Looks like bait fishing to me.
Pretty sure that's the case. Saw a little bit of a waggle. Nikki Bella, a 92 Viking based out of Jacksonville, Florida. Jr., our cameraman on board, Mark Blanton, the captain. So one of our Atlantic teams fishing in the Gulf. What do you think? Are they going to continue fishing the Atlantic to win an Atlantic title? There's only been one event, right? We still got more. Mm-hmm. Or do they just say, I want to finish in, say, top five here, maybe get another Gulf, maybe get another Atlantic, and just blend them all together? I just need three qualifying events.
Well, when you bring in the 90-footer part of it, you think to yourself, you know, that boat could pretty much go anywhere, anytime.
And back-to-back-to-back Gulf events as well. Yeah. I mean, they can still swing back around the east, or maybe they don't. Maybe they do that Texas run for the last Gulf and then go to Puerto Rico like we saw Quantified do last year.
Yeah, but that could happen too. There's a 50% chance.
Yeah. I mean, I would hit definitely if I've got the money and the time, you know they got the boat. If you could go back-to-back weeks after this one, make hay while the sun shines, bud, because you know there's a lot of blue marlin in these waters.
I was calling it bait fishing earlier. I have to change my call on this.
Well, championship fish bait, maybe.
Yeah.
And this is on day number two.
This is looking more and more like a yellowfin tuna.
Yeah. She down for the count for sure. Size-wise, we have yet to see a big yellowfin, have we?
Well, not in this tournament. Well,
not here in this tournament.
Right. Well,
other than the one that got away.
Yeah, Jason had one on. That was a really, really nice fish, and it was very unfortunate. It was a matter of seconds.
Yeah.
It was a matter of seconds.
And way that happened to bigger me. Equipment than you're seeing here, though, too, that she was fighting.
Oh yeah, you need heavy equipment. Or if you hooked a fish like she had with this kind of tackle, might fight it for 7 hours, 5 hours. I have guys in Miami, they strictly use 20-pound test with 30, 40, 50-pound leader on the kites because that's what we use for fish. So we could fly through the kites. It's lighter line. It sits better in the kites. Sometimes we even use 16. And sometimes these yellowfin 140-pounders roll through, and you'll be surprised, man. They will take 5-6 hours.
Okay, good
right,
one.
Right there.
That's a good one.
60-70-pounder.
60-pounder.
Look at the color in that thing. Nice color.
Nice catch.
Check it out. Yeah, that was nice. That was the right species.
Put it out for bait. Let's go. Let's win this thing.
What are you going to catch with that? What's Quantified going to catch? Are they going for the yellowfin? They've already caught sailfish. They've caught white marlin. This is earlier today. This is the first white marlin, and it wasn't their last white marlin. Let's take a look.
He snapped it out of that transom clip. That way he can be direct to the fish. Feeling the line in the fingers.
See the teasers
coming
in. Thumb
on the spool.
Very fast.
Yeah, the fish is jetting back and forth. They're in the turn, slowing it down. Everyone's able to see the fish. They're watching them closely, and the fish is watching the baits even closer.
Is he locked in at that point, or is he fully free spooling everything through the thumb?
There he is right there. He dropped back. He just locked it up. He puts the tip down. Let's see what happens. Okay, let's see. Yep, he looks like he's tight.
But I'm saying at that point, you don't hit the button and everything's in your thumb. You're living off of your thumb right then, right? Releasing and...
It's a very light thumb. That's what Chris Jones was really good at. I said, Chris, on this sailfish bite, you just got to drop back with a very light thumb, and he did it perfectly like a true champ. I was really impressed with that. Yep, he's got a white marlin on there. That was a nice feed, nice drop back, tip low, lock it up. Hooked up.
So you're saying Chris Jones, a big man with soft hands.
He's a big man with a lot of compliments, soft hands, a lot of humor. That guy brought so much energy to the boat. It was unbelievable.
You know our producer, Mike McInnes, is a lifetime Kansas City Chiefs fan, right? I
mean, I'm gonna have to get our producer, Mike McInnes, some seats at one of the Kansas City games. I know he wants to dress for the game. He wants to be on the team, but I think we're gonna have to put him in the bleachers a little further back.
As we're watching this, I believe it's our final segment for the YouTube stuff. I'm seeing more fish being caught this afternoon, later on in the day. Grocery Isle, Cotton Patch, Cold Blue. I'm seeing another one just a moment ago, Team Supreme with a blue marlin. So they're still catching them, just like Quantified did today, but not the blue marlin variety. They are going for whites and sails so far.
That's right, they're working that light tackle. They obviously have their blue marlin gear ready to go if they decide to make a move or change it up a bit to use live baits, to use big tunas or possibly pull lures. But, right now the white marlin bite for them is working, sails and whites. Just rack and stack And once again, once you find these fish and they're jumping and they're greyhounding and they're causing a big disturbance in the water, as you've seen in the teaser videos, there's always another few fish around. They may be deeper, they may be off to the side, but they're gonna watch, they're gonna hear it, they can feel the vibrations in their lateral lines, and they will come over and take a look. And that's why the rich get richer, as they say. That's why they're gonna catch maybe a few more fish if they stay in that area, because they're creating almost like a watering hole, right, you know, for these fish in this desert of nothing. They swim by and they see that, they're gonna hang out.
Oh, look
hey,
at this.
Keep working it. Keep working the circle. The circle of life.
Woo. We've got a jumper.
Yeah. Okay, light leader.
Kyler got that done. Down, doesn't he? So that was number one. They would catch two. They would catch three. And even though it hadn't popped up on our score sheet yet, they caught number four just a little while ago. And these are all white marlin.
That's right, number four, another 125 points if they get this fish to the boat. That looks like it could be Mr. James. I can't tell. His back's looking pretty jacked up.
I
Mr.
Knew
James
really
has been hitting the gym.
He's been working on his rhomboids and his deltoids and all the oids.
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of oids going on over there.
Kind of a calm. There, I'll hit right there.
I'm telling you, James has caught thousands of billfish. He's leadered thousands of billfish. He's staying calm, cool, collected. I mean, if that's him, if it's not him, it's one of the other guys that's done exactly the same. But this is how you do it, as the song goes.
I'm thinking all those trips to the gym. I mean, that boy works out.
Those are fishing muscles.
Yeah.
He doesn't have time to go to the gym. He's booked 24/7. I see posts of him getting on a plane like half the time, going to fly to some other country to go mate or be an angler or help run a boat or, you know, just be a super guy on the boat to have around that does absolutely everything.
While we got the time, and think about it, how wore out were the NFL guys, honestly, reeling in fish that were not this big? They were pretty tuckered at times, right? I mean, it just shows you there's a way to do it. And
not Tucker Wade, but they were tuckered out because, you know, these guys have big boy muscles, right? They're gigantic.
Yeah.
They get lactic acid buildup like you and I don't know about. We don't know about that life.
No, okay, lactic acid, but it's from the lack of working out.
Yeah, exactly. I got lactic acid just watching this guy catch his fish.
Yeah,
so
I had arm
these
pump
football
watching.
Players get out on the cockpit here and they start winding on these fish, and they're under pressure and they know they want to get that fish to the boat faster than the other guy. They're so competitive, so they burn themselves out. That's truly what happens. You know, if they took their time and if they, like Chris Jones did, I said, Chris, when the fish runs, extend your arm. But he fishes, so he knows. I said, when that fish is running, extend your arm. Your bicep is your smallest muscle in your body. You just gotta let the fish run.
Just gotta let it go.
Yeah.
That's your quadricep of your arm, I thought. I thought that was a big one, or is that the
bicep? No, tricep is bigger than your bicep.
Yeah.
But that's that horseshoe, it's got like a double treble.
Yeah.
Tripod.
I used to have that.
Like mini me in Austin Powers. Looks like a little tripod. So,
I feel
you know, you keep the arm, you know, you don't want to be always like just crunching your bicep. You don't want to do bicep crunches the entire time. You know, you want to extend that arm like he's doing, let it run.
He's stretching that arm.
Exactly.
Too.
That is James. Mr. James. He's not a junior angler anymore. He's with the big boys.
Grab it up. Look at their dredge. Shows you how they're tantalizing. That James
actually,
or Kyler?
Actually, I don't think that was.
I think that might be Kyler.
I think that was somebody else.
Danny, was that Kyler?
Man. James, Jason, all the things I said are still stick. Okay?
Just switch the name.
Everything I said, yeah, we're going to switch exactly.
The name.
All three of the guys doing all exactly the same thing.
I think that was Justin's son, but you know what? They're both well built.
Congratulations to the Quantify for catching a fourth white marlin to add to their two sailfish. giving them solid second place situation, and they are sitting.
What happened? Look at our updates. I don't want to tease it. Yeah. If they were in second, it was for a split second because the updates are flying. And currently, look at this now. Now you see why they're not in second. Multiple teams, Code Blue catching two here in the afternoon, Dragon Up, Team Supreme, all with double Blue Marlin catches on the day. They're flying now, Peter. It's that magic feeding time we've been talking about. Just when Quantified looked good, jumped up into second, you see those. So now at the point for Quantified, they need some blues.
They're 50 points away from being tied for first place.
50. You better get back to that abacus.
Hey, guys, you got to join us tomorrow at 1 p.m. Eastern time on CBS Sports, where the action continues tomorrow.
The passion's real, Peter. We're going to do it again. And we're going to do it again.
Oh, it's
not
real.
Not only on CBS, we're going to actually try and get you the official winner because it'll be, they'll still have some fishing time. The thing is, they have to be back, what's that time? At like 6 o'clock, I think. 6 o'clock, the scales close. If they're inside that Mississippi Sound, they can fish up until that last second.
And hey, don't forget to watch If I Eat That Hard or Not tomorrow morning on the Discovery Channel at 8 a.m. on Uncharted Waters. Chris Jones offered me $5,000 to eat a live heart out of a tuna.
Hey, thanks for those shots, too. Those are some sweet picks. And forget about that one fish. Look at the other 10 hanging around it. Stick with us tomorrow on CBS Sports Network.